This is Talk Business and Politics with Roby Brock.
And welcome to the program. I'm Roby Brock. Earlier this month, Crystal Bridges Museum of American Art in Bentonville announced that Olivia Walton, niece by marriage to founder Alice Walton, would take over as chair of the board of directors. Olivia Walton is impressive. She's a former NBC and Bloomberg technology reporter, but she has a lifetime in the arts. We caught up for a conversation. Well, Olivia, thank you so much for making time to be with us. You have lived in New York, you've lived in Philadelphia, you've lived in London. I'm thinking that Bentonville is a little different pace. Tell me what you like about Northwest Arkansas.
My friends ask me that all the time, and I say, you know, same, same. I love it here, and I have two little girls now, and I have to tell you, this might be the easiest place in America to raise small children. I think that Bentonville is well on its way to my husband's mission of making Bentonville, Arkansas, the best place to live in America. And it's so exciting to be part of the work that he and his whole family are doing, making these big investments in the arts and biking and increasingly in health and wellness. And so I'm just excited about it. And wow, what a rapidly transforming place it is to be.
Yes, as an Arkansas native who's lived here my half century plus, I have seen Bentonville come make great strides in the last decade to two decades, so for sure. Let's talk about your role with the Crystal Bridges Museum. You're an art junkie. Your mom was an art dealer, I believe. You've loved and lived around art your whole life. Maybe speak to a little bit of your art philosophy to me. Why has it always appealed to you, and what does art do to you?
Yeah, I have really been sort of a lifelong museum junkie. I think that art has this incredible power to inspire creativity, to inspire new ways of seeing, to inspire new ways of thinking. Alice has this expression, she says, if you have access to art, you have access to imagination. And if you have imagination, you have hope. And I just think that's a beautiful sentiment. So I really think that art has the power to lift the spirit. And I think that museums are incredibly powerful. I mean, museums are able to educate, they are able to entertain, they are able to inspire, they are able to build community. So it's really an exciting thing. I actually was making a comparison to my husband, Tom, who you know, he's so crazy about mountain biking and living outdoors, which I love too, but he describes himself as having this feeling of being in nature makes him feel really small. There's this shrinking of self. And honestly, for me, being in an amazing museum, it has a similar feeling. You know, your sense of self just kind of shrinks as you admire hundreds of years of creativity and civilization and culture. It's just kind of exciting. So I'm a big believer. And also, I would just say, I came into this as the daughter of an art dealer, as a art history minor, as a lifelong art lover, but I actually love and am inspired by Alice's take on art, because Alice really believes in having kind of expanding the definition of art. And as she would say, of not letting sort of an elite group of art critics on the coast tell us what is great art and what we should think about it.
I want to explore that theme a little bit. I have that in my notes here. You said in your statement when the press release came out that you were going to be taking over as the board chair that we should expand our definition of art. What does that mean? Where do you think that's going to take us?
On the one hand, expanding the definition of art means expanding more and more into art as culture. It means performing arts. It means music. It could be culinary. In the Crystal Bridges physical expansion, expanding our definition of art goes alongside these two big commitments we announced, a commitment to craft and a commitment to indigenous art. So craft typically is what I call has been the medium of the marginalized, right? And for a long time, the only people who had access to art school and oil paints tended to be wealthy, white, and overwhelmingly male. And so if you look at craft and you look at the rich history of craft in this region. I mean, so often that was the artistic creative outlet for those who just didn't have access to those things. So it's really exciting to bring that into the museum, to put it on a pedestal, to shine a light, and to tell those stories.
You wanted to run the Metropolitan Museum of Art, you said in one interview. Crystal Bridges may be a better gig, true or false?
True. Oh, very much true. Although I do still love the Metropolitan and was actually lucky to be there last week. No, true. If for nothing else, I mean, for so many reasons. But I just love how progressively Alice and all the staff think about reaching people in their mission to expand access. And so at Crystal Bridges, you know, we are art, architecture, and nature. We are able to reach hundreds of thousands more people outdoors, you know, with the sculpture on the North Forest trails and all that stuff. So I think it's more compelling offer.
What does it take to run an art museum? What's the skill set? What's the vision? Kind of what do you expect to bring to the table that, not that Alice hasn't laid a great foundation over the last 10 years, but I think that your expectation is going to be to elevate what she started.
Yeah, Alice has laid an incredible foundation. She's been a very generous mentor to me over the past few years. The staff is outstanding. Rod Bigelow, our director, is terrific, and he has a really strong executive staff. So they're making this pretty easy for me. I would like to be helpful with bringing in new ideas and partnerships. Those are things that are easier for me perhaps to make happen as I'm out there traveling through the world, and I've lived in different places, as you noted. So, you know, there's a, not to give you too much of a sneak peek, but, you know, I've seen creative arts and crafts retail that we can, you know, bring into the store, or I see new concerts that I think, oh, we could do something like that at Crystal Bridges. So I think I would like to be a bridge and cheerleader for Crystal Bridges to other organizations and institutions across the country.
You have been the leader of the Momentary, which is right there next to Crystal Bridges. Is that role going to change for you? Is someone else going to lead that organization? Are you going to wear two hats?
I'm going to wear two hats, but it's not like one plus one. It's like 1 + 1 = 1.5 because the Momentary Council reports up to the Crystal Bridges Board. So it's going to be terrific to do both of them. I'm really excited about what's happening at the Momentary. That was a very awkward start to close 3 weeks after we opened. We pivoted this summer, you might have seen, to double down on music. We feel like music is kind of a better olive branch to make more people feel welcome on our campus who perhaps are not familiar with attending arts organizations regularly. People come back to listen to music more often than they go to a museum. And they also bring a little bit more stoke than even the best art lovers. So I think the Momentary is well on its way to becoming our original vision of a living room for the community. We might tweak a couple more things in the downstairs atrium. We might bring in an awesome restaurant. So I think a lot's happening there, and it'll be relatively easy.
Tell me a little bit about one of the original copies of the U.S. Constitution is going to be loaned to the Crystal Bridges Museum. Why don't you tell me what your expectations are for that? How long might it be on display?
Oh, we are super excited about this. And I have to tell you, this is kind of a story about the value of being back in person. So I just happened to be at Sotheby's in New York City last week with a group of Crystal Bridges supporters who we take on these great trips from time to time. And Rod Bigelow, our director, sort of said, gosh, wouldn't it be great if the winner just lent it to Crystal Bridges so we can display it? And I happened to know Brooke, who had the winning bidder on the phone, who works at Sotheby's. And I said, Brooke, you should just say to whoever won it, you know, we could put it on display tomorrow. And she said, okay, I'll tell him. So she told him and he said, yes, we don't have a relationship with Ken Griffin. And we're just so grateful and excited that the U.S. Constitution is coming to Bentonville, Arkansas.
Well, you have a relationship with him now, that's for sure.
We do. And I'm really excited about the programming that we're going to be able to put on around the Constitution. I think it's going to bring a whole new group of people onto the museum's campus. And it's an opportunity to introduce them to Crystal Bridges and what we're doing, trying to tell a more inclusive story of the history of American art.